Before the start of the pandemic, the Chicago River Walk generated $16.5 million in revenue during the 2019 season. That's according to the city. It's become a destination for tourists. It wasn't always that way. In fact, people used to turn their back on the river due to pollution. Today, keeping it clean is a must as developers and businesses dive into its potential. Chicago's river comes with a historic wake, a trail of bridges and beauty that define it. Few people know more about it than Margaret Frisbee.
So you've seen its growth.
Well, I mean, I can remember as a kid, I would go canoeing with my dad. Have fun.
There were no fish because of sewage in the river.
A lot has changed since then. She now leads the nonprofit Friends of the Chicago River. I took her along to tour part of the river with me on what is the anniversary of the Clean Water Act.
Came into law in October 18th of 1972.
50 years ago, it turned the tide to get the river to where it is today. What helped clean it up? Natural plantings, a deep tunnel system, and disinfection projects for water flowing into the river.
There's a ton of wildlife. Way more than people expect, which is one of the fun surprises, I think, about the river.
And the health of the river has also inspired the wave of development that's coming.
In my years here, the river is much cleaner than it ever be. It has ever been. It really is incredibly clean. There was always trash.
Guest number 83.
Kurt Schweig runs Lawrence's Fish and Shrimp.
Thank you so much.
The food fan favorite has been along the river for decades. It will soon have some company.
Is this the most interest you've seen in developing along the river in the 50 years that you've been here?
Certainly in my involvement.
Here's your bird's eye view of what's expected in just the next few years. From north to south and in between, it includes residential, office space, even a research facility, and the project that's getting the most attention, the mega casino at the old Chicago Tribune printing facility.
So you see it as a good thing?
I do. Yeah. I think with moderation. I mean, that's obviously why they have a plan commission, so that somebody doesn't come in and overbuild.
It's that master plan on how to redevelop that's been in the works for years now. Over the last 5 years, the Planning Commission has approved 25,000 new housing units and 10 million square feet of office space on the riverfront.
A lot of these developments are happening in former industrial areas. So we are changing the formerly industrial uses to a mixed use development.
We don't want to see the whole Riverwalk developed with this really dense, you know, impermeable surface, restaurants. We want to have quiet places where people can contemplate the river, they can bring their kids and have fun.
All of it brings us back to Margaret.
And so what we're always pushing for is this idea that people and nature can thrive together.
Yes, she wants to see river redevelopment with clean water in mind. The expected approval of the $1.8 billion new casino rocked the boat at first, but Margaret says that's changing.
And if you look at what's on the site right now, we're not interacting with the river. There's no public access. There's no habitat. And so reconfiguring this to a new use actually provides opportunity to have bird habitat, turtle habitat, fish habitat, human habitat.
The casino will have a mandatory 30-foot setback from the water, allowing for natural planting, similar to these marsh restoration projects that help with water quality. It will also have a public river walk to be used by anyone.
If you were a 15-year-old boy with your friends, you should feel as welcome here as someone who is a patron of the casino.
It may take years to piece it all together, but the big vision is a connected public walkway that stretches for miles.
Mostly, the density is a better thing in our mind, as long as you are considering the river as a natural resource rather than a water feature.
Above all, keeping a clean waterway is key, a lesson Chicago learned decades ago.
And the Clean Water Act is the fundamental tool in the United States, and it's worth its weight in gold.
And recently, the Clean Water Act made headlines as the Supreme Court took up the way the act defines wetlands. Several conservative justices expressed concern about the law's broad reach and debated narrowing protections. It's an issue Chicago River advocates keep a close watch on as they celebrate 50 years of the start of a journey that's transforming one of Chicago's most famous waterways. I'm Lourdes Duarte, WGN News.